Next is an initiation lecture given by His Divine Grace, A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Prabhupada, recorded on December 19, 1968, in Los Angeles.
I am not criticizing, but it is human consideration. Suppose if you have committed some wrong thing within our jurisdiction, and you come to me, Swamiji, I have committed this. I say, all right, don't do it, excuse. Now, second day you come again, you say, I have committed this. All right, second day I can also excuse. The third day also I can excuse, but fourth day I will not excuse. Don't make it official business. Just like go to the church every week and confess. And you're confessing your sinful activities before Lord Jesus Christ or His representative, surely your sinful activities are squared up. But does it mean very nice that every week, the whole week you shall commit sinful activities and at the end of the week you shall go and confess? Does it look very well? You are not ashamed that every week I commit these sinful activities and on the seventh day I confess. This process should not be adopted. That because God's name, God's remembrance actually squares up all our sinful activities, that's a fact. But how it is that we shall go on committing sinful activities and square it up by chanting Hare Krishna or by confessing? No. This is the particular point one should carefully know. Just like Jagai Madhai. Jagai Madhai, they are the greatest sinful men during Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's time. So, when they surrendered to Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu with confession, my Lord, we have committed so many sinful activities, please save us. The Chaitanya Mahaprabhu asked them that, yes, I will accept you and I will save you, provided you promise that no more you shall commit such sinful activities. So they agreed, yes, whatever we have done, that's all. No more we are going to do. Then Chaitanya Mahaprabhu accepted them and they became great devotees and their life was successful. The same process is here also. This initiation means that everyone should remember that whatever sinful activities one might have done in his past life, that is now account closed, debit and credit closed. Now, from this day, no more sinful activities. What are those sinful activities? That is very simple, we have mentioned, you should take it note. No illicit sexuality. Beyond marriage, there is no sex life. No intoxication. Even drinking tea, coffee, they are also intoxication. Cigarette, smoking, no intoxication. No meat eating. Simple. Only Krishna prasada. Whatever, if you remain in the temple, you will get this Krishna prasadam. And if not, outside, you prepare your chapati, dal, offer to Krishna and take. Don't take anything except Krishna prasad. The third, and no gambling or unnecessary sporting. People are wasting time. So many sporting they have invented, exporting balls, this ball, that ball. You see, the human life is very short. You do not know when we shall die. Before that, we must prepare ourselves for the next life. Next life means directly going back to Krishna, highest perfection. As we will find in the Bhagavad Gita, Janti Deva Vrata Devan Pitri Janti Pitri Vrata. There are innumerable varieties of planet. They have planetary system. They are resided by demigods, very powerful. They are also human beings, but they are very beautiful, they are very powerful. So you can go there. The moon planet, sun planet, that is clearly stated. If you act accordingly as they prescribe, that if you want to go to the moon planet, you have to do like this, then after leaving this body you can go there. Similarly, you can go any planet. Similarly, you can go to the planet of Krishna.